Okay, this lesson is for interpreting graphs, increasing and decreasing functions. All right, so definition first. A function f is increasing whenever this y-coordinate is greater than this y-coordinate as you move left to right along the x-axis. It's like a line with a positive slope, so that as you go left to right, is if you're going up, that's an increasing function. And when you're asked where a function is increasing, just like we've been learning, the function is f of x. So when you're asked when is y increasing, you're going to state the x's that make it happen in interval notation. The function is decreasing whenever this y-coordinate is less than this y-coordinate as you move left to right. So this is a decreasing line. Okay, so example two, number two example, estimate the intervals on which f of x equals negative 2x to the fifth minus 8x to the fourth minus 4x cubed plus 10x squared plus 6x is increasing, and the intervals on which the function is decreasing. So over here, this is the function. It's a fifth degree function, and it has a lot of local mins and local maxes. So that gives us a lot of places where the function is increasing and decreasing. So with my yellow highlighter, I'm going to find the places where the function is increasing. So this, from left to right, the function is going up. So this is where the function is increasing. Okay, and so now what we want to do is we want to focus on the x values that are making that those y values do that. So what you want to do is you want to find the local min, which I've already found here, and this local max, which I found here, and the x's are making the function do that. So just ignore the y's. You might even cross them out, so you won't write them down. So the function is increasing from parentheses negative 2.393, this x coordinate here, and you don't include the endpoint because technically it's neither increasing nor decreasing here at this point because it's changing. So that's why you have parentheses. And so we keep going, all of these x values from when x is negative 2.393 to when x is negative 1.234, union, again parentheses, here is when it starts to increase again, when x is negative 0.285 all the way up to when x is 0.713. So these are all x values. This is where the function is increasing. Okay, so where's the function decreasing? Well, I'll use my orange highlighter. The function is going down as you go left or right here, and here, and here. So we want to use these local mins and local max points, but we're answering the question, what are the x values that are making the function decrease? And we have to go left to right, smaller to larger. So we have to start, you know, it looks like it's going straight up and down, but it's not. It's kind of diagonal. So you have to understand that we're talking about the x values. This is going to take a long time to get way over here, but it's going to get way over here. So the x values that make this function decrease as you go left to right are actually from negative infinity till we get to x equals negative 2.393. So we're thinking horizontally even though we're seeing a vertical line because we're trying to pull it right down the x values. All right, union from when x is negative 0.12, negative 1.234 to when x is negative 0.285 right there. We're looking at the x's that are making that happen. Union when x is 0.713 to infinity. And again, you have to change the way you're thinking. These are the y values, but the x values that are making it happen are going towards infinity. All right, and then again, we've got local min and local max definitions, and we've actually already gone over it. A local max occurs when the function is changing from increasing to decreasing. And a local min occurs when the function is changing from decreasing to increasing. And so we're looking for maximums. They're going to have a kind of a mountain peak, increasing to decreasing. And for minimums, you're going to have like a valley. You can't have local mins and maxes at endpoints. Okay, and so we've already done this before, but this time I've changed the way that I'm asking it. So I reviewed it in the last video. The minimums and the maximum are actually the y coordinates, and then when is it, what x phase is making it happen. So we have a local minimum here. So there is a local minimum of negative 7.674 when x is negative 0.2393. We have another local minimum here because it's changing from decreasing to increasing when y is 854. That is your minimum. That is the lowest y value in that area when x is negative 0.285. We have a local maximum here because we're changing from increasing to decreasing. That's the highest y value in that area. And that is 2.512 when x is negative 1.234. And there is another local max right here. I'm going to erase these x marks on the y coordinates because you need them in this context. So there's a local max at 5.476 when x is 0.713. Absolute extrema. Are there any absolute extrema? That means any absolute maximums? Is there a y value that's higher than all the other y values? Well, no, because this function goes on forever and ever. Is there any absolute minimums? Any y value that's lower than all the rest? Well, no, because it's going on forever down towards negative infinity, so there are none. All right, so if you want to practice, you can stop the video. Before you do that, though, I just want to, it's hard to see. This is a gray point, so this is a point, but this is indeed a hole. Okay, so if you want to stop the video and determine the intervals when the following functions are increasing and decreasing and classify all extrema, you can do that. Okay, so where is the function increasing? It's increasing right here and right here. So this is the point -1, -2, -3. So it's increasing from -3 to -1.309 parentheses union parentheses 3.309. And then this is the point 5, and it's an open circle, so we'll have parentheses there. So we have x values, and they are always in order from smallest to largest. You have to go left to right. And then it's decreasing right here. All right, so that means it is decreasing from when x is negative 1.309 to when x is 3.309, and use parentheses. Classify all extrema. I'm just going to jot it down. This is a local min right here. This is a local max. Are there any absolute extrema? Well, yes, this is the highest y value that you can get, so this is also an absolute max. And this is the lowest y value you get, so this is also an absolute min. All right, we want to try this one. Okay, the notation here means that this goes on forever and ever. It goes down here. All right, so if we want to know where it's increasing, as you go from left to right, the function goes up right here. It's increasing. So it's increasing when x is from parentheses negative 10 to when x is 3.333, and it's decreasing right here. And you have to go left to right, so the first thing we're going to say is not positive infinity. Okay, so it's hard because you're looking here and your brain wants to say, oh, positive infinity, but we've got to transfer that down. This is actually increasing, or excuse me, decreasing when x is from here to here and when x is from there to there. It's a really hard thing to for students is when you're typing in WebAssign, that's a big error. So negative infinity, all these x's till you get to negative 10, it's decreasing. Union, then it starts when x is 3.333 and it's continuing to increase, not toward negative infinity, when x goes to positive infinity. So that's the trickiest thing, is that you want to talk about the y's, but these are all x values, so you want to transfer that down here. This is from negative infinity to this negative 10 that this function is increasing, and from 3.333 to infinity that this function is decreasing. I think I might have said increasing. These are both decreasing here. All right, and then local extrema, well, this is a local max, and this is a local min, and it doesn't have any absolute maxes or mins on this one. Okay, same thing here. Where is the function increasing and decreasing? All right, so the function is increasing here and here. And we want x values, so it's increasing from when x is negative 3.606 to 0, union 3.606 to infinity. Those x values are making the function increase. It's decreasing here to here, and there to there. All right, now don't make the mistake. I'll transfer it onto the x-axis. So this is going up to positive infinity, but we want to know what x values are making the function decrease. So that's actually this. So from when x is from negative infinity to when x is negative 3.606, the function is decreasing. Union 0 to 3.606. Pretty tricky here. All right, classify extrema. This is a local min. This is a local min. This is a local max. These two are also absolute maxes. Remember, the y coordinate is the max. So, see, they both have negative. Let's say min. They both have a negative 1.44. So, absolute min is negative 1.44. That is the absolute min. That's the lowest y you could get. But it occurs when x is either plus or minus 3.606. All right, and then this last one, where is the function increasing? Well, that's right here. From left to right, this function is going up. So it is increasing when x is bracket 2 to, what is this point here? Point is 5, 3. We just care about the 5. And it's decreasing. Oop, there's a hole there, open circle. Okay, so it's decreasing from when x is negative 5 to when x is 2. All right, now we've actually done something like this before. I'll talk you through number 6, and then you can try number 7. It says, draw a graph that fulfills the following characteristics. It has a local minimum when x is equal to negative 5. It has a local maximum when x is 5. And it's greater than 0 when x is less than 8. So here is 6, 7, 8. And the function is above the x-axis, greater than 0 when x is less than 8. So that was the graph that I came up with. Okay, it's not the only graph, but that's one of them. All right, so you might want to pause the video and try this one. It says, draw a graph that fulfills the following characteristics. X has a local max at x equals negative 5 again. So somewhere up here, we got one of these things going on. And as a local min, when x is 3, so I'm going to go underneath the x-axis unless I have to change it. Doesn't have to be. It could be like this. Above the x-axis. It's greater than 0 when x is above 6. So the function does need to be greater than 0 when x is greater than 6. And then it's absolute maximum at x equal 9. So that means that's the highest it can be. So I'll make a point right here. And then it has no absolute minimum. Okay. So I've kind of got an idea of what I need. So now I'm going to start. It has a local maximum at x equals 5 and no absolute minimum. So I know that I can do this. It has a local maximum when x is 3. It's only got to be above the x-axis when x is greater than 6, so I can go underneath the x-axis. And then if it's got to be greater than 0, not greater than or equal to 0, when x is greater than 6. So here's 6. So I don't think I need to do anything there. And turn it around. So let's make sure that's right. Is the function greater than 0 as long as x is greater than 6? Yep. Is that an absolute maximum at x equal 9? Yeah. Is it true that it has no absolute minimum? Yes. And it does have an absolute maximum. So that's just my example there.